All right, welcome to MrCross.org. Today we're going to have some fun. We're going to actually go to the MrCross website, and we're going to go to Computer Applications 1, and we're going to make some music without installing software. We're really talking about cloud computing here, and as an example, I showed OnLive, which is a new video game service that's been coming out. It's a video game platform that's all in the cloud, and music creation, image editing, all of these types of things can now be done without the software being installed on your computer. So we're going to do some of that today. So to do this today, we're going to need to open up a few different tabs. We're going to open up this clubcreate.com website, and while we're waiting for that to load, we're actually going to go back and open up Google Apps as well, because once we're finished with our audio edit, we're going to actually put the music onto our website. Let's go back to ClubCreate. We're going to use this Dubstep Studio as soon as it comes back around here. There's three or four different programs that you can use, and we're going to use one in particular, and it is this guy right here. So we're going to click to launch, and this is going to open up a software program, basically, that looks something like this, and it's loading right as we speak. And this is a drag and drop, point and click kind of a audio editor, and what it does is you have pre-made sounds that have been recorded and uploaded to the server, and we're gonna rearrange where those sounds go. So we're gonna put them on the timeline, and then we're gonna hit play, and those sounds are then going to create our song. This is what they commonly call loop-based editing.
You will.
And we're gonna go ahead and hit click to mix, and so here we are. This is actually the editor. Over here you've got an add sounds button, and then you've got your sound effects. So we're going to go through here, and we're going to add some drums first. Let's see. You can click on them and let them load, and then you'll get the sound itself. And then we're going to drag and drop, hit the add button to get the sound onto the stage. Now, I don't think in this you're hearing these sounds, because you can only hear my microphone, so you might not be getting all these sounds real well. But you'll... they're very high quality, and they'll work real well in your production. And I like the sound of that, so I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. Alright, so let me listen to my song. Alright, I got some drums, and you kind of get the picture. We'll keep adding and layering sounds until we have a pretty good sounding presentation going. So now what we need to do is we need to go to register. And you're going to put your name, your email address, and a password in there to get registered for an account so that we can save it. I've already done one, so I'm going to log in. And once I have logged in, it's going to give me the ability to save this file. And when I do, I just have to give it a name. I'm going to call it example, and I'm going to hit the button. And now I actually have it. In fact, I have two songs. I have one called Something and one called Example. When I go to open, and Example is the one that we just created, which is right here. Alright, so we're all done there. Let's go ahead and talk about sharing real quick. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually share this, and if you have a Twitter or a Facebook, you can actually share this song through those services as well. But we're going to actually do this. We're going to click on this, and we're going to say copy, because what we want to do is we want to take this embedded code and we want to put it into our website. So let's go back to our Google Docs here. We're going to go to Sites, and I'm going to pick one of my sites that I've created, and I'm going to create a page, just a standard old plain web page. I'm going to give it a name called Music, and I want it at the top level. I'm going to create that page. Now I have some HTML code, and if I wanted to just type and I hit Control V, this will just show the text to the people, and this is what they'll see on my website. And that's not what we want to do. There's a button right up here that says HTML in it, Edit HTML Source. We're going to edit the code of the page, basically. And when I click that, it gives me a different looking screen. And I'm going to get rid of everything that they have already preset, and I'm going to hit Control V, and this is going to put the HTML code into my document. Now watch what happens when I say update. It's going to give me a little thing that says Google Gadget, embed gadget. So it's embedded the code into my website. Now when I hit save, I now have the code that is showing my music player right there in my music website. So I can go to click on my music tab, and there I go. Now if I want to listen to it, I can hit this, and there we go. We just created our song all right within the confines of this one thing. So I hope this helps, and I'm going to have to answer the phone now. Talk to you later. Bye.